Hello everyone and welcome to the short video tutorial series of Planit Pro. I'm Mike Shaw. In this video, we'll talk about the search and the current location features. Most plans start with the location search. For example, it could be the plan's camera location, the scene, or subject location. The location search function is at the magnifying glass icon in the upper right corner. Click it and you'll see an input box where you can enter a place name or a latitude and longitude. If we want to choose the Empire State Building in New York City as our target, we simply search for the name. The first item on the list is the one that we're looking for. Tap it to go there on the map, and here it is. There is one thing to note. Many people think searching a building will select the center of the building, so they set it as the scene location like this without really thinking about it. However, it's not always the case. For the case of the Empire State Building, you can see the base is from here all the way around. We can draw two lines connecting two opposite corners like this. The two lines will intersect at the center. So the actual center of the building is here. It is slightly different from the selected location. This minor error is okay for most general plans, but still, if you're looking for a precise alignment, it could fail your plan, especially during a time lapse where you can't move the camera location in the middle. So one needs to be careful and accurate about these details. You can also search in another language, for example in French, Tour Eiffel. It will find the Eiffel Tower in Paris, France. How about in Japanese, Fujisan, which is Mount Fuji. It found the correct one as well. Now a search may return no results. That's because the search engine we're using doesn't have the information for that name. So sometimes you feel lost when this happens, and there are ways around it. First, you can use the Google Map app to search for the name like this. Then you can press and hold the map to select a location, swipe up the bottom sheet to find the coordinates, press and hold to copy it, go back to Planit, tap the search button, press and hold, and paste it into Search's search box like this. As you can see, Planit can accept coordinates. They're just two numbers separated by a comma. It means Planit can go anywhere on Earth using these coordinates. On some other websites, we may see a coordinate format like this. Planit can recognize it as well. Copy it, go to Planit, tap the search, press and hold, then paste. See, it works just fine. If you can't copy and paste coordinates, for example you found coordinates in a paper book, you can still type the coordinates manually. To make it simple, you can replace the special symbols such as degrees, minutes, and seconds with white space. Using the same example as above, the latitude will become like this. Those three numbers are degrees, minutes, and seconds, respectively, separated by white space. We can still recognize them as long as they're in the correct order. Put a comma, then the longitude, and see it works. Some coordinate formats contain direction letters such as N, S, E, W, which stands for north, south, east, and west, respectively. Can Planit understand those formats? Of course. As long as it's not a wrong or ambiguous format, Planit can read it. Next, let's talk about the current location feature. When you plan for a future shot at a different location, you use the location search I mentioned earlier. But when you're at the location, you want to find the ephemeris information for your now current location. To do so, tap this button to center the map at your current location. And then you can set the camera location at the map center. If this button is not working, there could be two reasons. The first is you didn't give Planit permission to access the current location. The second reason, which is only for Android, is your phone may not have the Google Play service installed or enabled. If so, press and holding this button, you can select a different current location provider. Just choose one that works. If you're on iOS, pressing and holding this button does nothing because iOS only has one location provider. We can zoom in and take a look. The blue dot shows where you are on the map. However, when you use it, you may find the blue dot sometimes drifts around. That's because the phone isn't sure about your location either. You'll see a light blue circle around the blue dot, and this light blue circle represents the accuracy of the current positioning. It means that your actual location is possibly anywhere in this light blue circle. The higher the precision, the smaller the light blue circle will be. Generally speaking, the current location should be very accurate when you're in an open space without any buildings blocking it. However, when we're in a city with many high buildings, this GPS signal will be blocked or bounced by all the buildings and will cause the phone to indicate the wrong location, which again will cause our precise alignment plan to fail. In these cases, I suggest you ignore the blue dot and instead zoom in on the satellite map and find one or more reference points on the ground to determine your location. For example, if the camera location or your plan is over here, there is a line on the ground right here. So when you go there, forget the blue dot and just find that line and stand on it. That's more reliable than the blue dot in this case. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching and enjoy learning and using Planit.